What's going on YouTube? Welcome back to video 2. Today I'm going to run you through one of my chest days. I'm on push-pull legs right now, so I have two push days or chest days every single week. And the most common question I think I get asked on Instagram is like how I got my chest striations. And to be honest, I don't really know how I got them. They just kind of showed up. But I did some research after people started asking to try to find out how I got them, and I think I know. So I'll run you through one of my chest workouts, but I think the main way I got my chest striations is one thing I've been doing ever since I started working out, and like without even knowing it. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoy this workout, and I hope you guys can learn something from it.
For the two of us.
What's that? That's for the two of us?
Batman likes to play the hero, and he's pretty good at it, but it's an act. Batman's not about saving the innocent, no, no, he's about punishing the guilty. Jump ahead and slow, jump ahead and slow. Had to tell my bro, yeah, had to train the drone. Had to train my diamonds, yeah, they smoking head of tone. About what you say, yes, it's shut up, let me go. Riding in that deal, let me tell the truth. Ride around, keep breath down, what you say, I got my blinking truck. Head number one up on each type of year, it's still the work. I'll be doing to go number one. And I just brought it from ends, the bitch is the first of the month. Ran around, I'm in the game, the bitch is my chair, the city was ready to sun. I went and paid in the band, let's reach it.
So I have two different bench days. For one, I'll climb up to a heavy single. And then for another bench day, I'll do more reps of like 225. And Monday is my rep day, so I'm gonna go for, usually I do a 4x8 of 225, but because I'm like prepping right now, I'm kind of weak, so instead I'm gonna go for an 8x7x6x6, because I don't think I'll get a 4x8, but I'm gonna go for a 4x8, and if I get it, then fuck it. I'm about to bring this shit back and away from the top at the time of the month. I'm about to do it and get ready to do it and get ready to shit with a song. He gon' talk to me, he gon' talk to me. He gon' talk to me, he gon' talk to me. I'm gonna fuck you, Sam, I'm gonna be the last hit. He got me right now, you know me, he got me right red. I'm here with the crew, yeah, put the boots on dance. You ain't gonna make no money, that don't make no sense. All right, what do you do? One more set of just 175 to burn out and warm up the chest a little bit, and then I'll meet you guys at the next workout. Bro really brought a camera into a fucking.
Are you gonna wash your hands? Are you gonna wash your hands?
Got my chest right, and I don't really know how the fuck I got them. They just kind of showed up, but I did some research once people started asking, and I found out, I think it's because of stretching. Every single time in between my workouts, I do this stretch. Come here. In between every single one of my sets, I do this stretch right here, and I've been doing it for like years. Just because basically it feels good, and I think it's what caused my chest striation. So that's cause number one, I guess you could say.
I was looking delicious, and she was looking delicious, and all of a sudden, it just
and it was in. It was crazy.
Was it worth it?
No. Have a good rest of your night. I'm gonna miss you.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
I'm going to jack off.
Hey guys, so this isn't the best camera setup right now. I'm sitting on the floor. But anyways, yeah, that was my chest day, basically. That's kind of my push day every single time. I always warm up and then start immediately with bench. And then I'll jump back and forth between different chest and shoulder workouts. Sometimes I change up the workouts, but I always bench, I always shoulder press, and I always do flies, and then I'll end it with tries. And like I said, the main way I got my striations is probably that stretch. I've been doing it for years in between my sets. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoy. Go try out the workout if you want. But yeah, I'm really tired right now and I'm all gross, so I gotta take a shower and go to bed. But going to Texas, stopping in Austin for some gyms, and then Houston for Alpha Land, of course. So I got a lot of cool content on the way. But I wanted to talk a little bit about like new lifters and just coming into the gym for your first time, since a lot of you guys might be new to the gym because January 1st and everything like that. And it can get a little bit discouraging looking around and seeing guys that have been in the gym for years and have impressive physiques. And you almost just want that like immediately. But I just wanted to say, like, you got to fall in love with the journey and the process and fall in love with the gym and don't chase that end result. Obviously, you should chase the end result and have goals, but just fall in love with the journey. One day you'll look back and you'll see where you came from and be really proud that you started. So that's like my main tip for beginner lifters, is just you gotta fall in love with the journey rather than trying to always have your eyes on the end goal, you know? But yeah, anyways, like I said, I'm gonna get some sleep. Just remember guys, you can accomplish anything you want, any physique you want. You can look however you want. Well, you know, as far as your genetics allow, but yeah, have a good night and I will see you guys in Texas next week.